Who is going next?
Ma'am, can I? Anushka.
Yes, please. Yes, Anushka.
Sharing the photo of the question.
We need a close-up. Explain the concept of alternative care for children. Differentiate between various kinds of alternate care systems.
Can this be done?
Well, I'm asking everybody else to respond. Everything can be done. That's not a question, it can be done or not. The question is more that when we are writing the question, what is it that we expect our students to write as a response?
Yes, ma'am.
And whether what we expected is what the students understood it to mean. Mm-hmm. That's the only thing we are doing today.
Right, ma'am.
So anyone who has a response? Mm-hmm. When you will explain the concept of alternative care for children, Anushka, do you think we'll also have to talk about various kinds? You suppose we had only the first
okay,
part.
Okay, ma'am, right.
If we had only the first part.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Then we'll have to do the second also.
Right, ma'am. Right, ma'am. Right.
Right, okay. Ma'am. Okay, next one. It's simple.
Okay, ma'am.
Yeah, but no, it's, of
this
course,
is the only one, question. This
at
is
one level, at one level, it does clarify to the student that this is also they're supposed to.
Mm-hmm.
But the moment you say explain, mm-hmm, it will have to talk about the different kinds.
But then, ma'am, I'm talking also about differentiating properly the nuances between the all four in case they exist. With that view in mind, I'm giving the second part.
If you were to say explain alternate care for children, mm-hmm, and then you have said yes, differentiate, ma'am. But the moment you say the concept,
right, ma'am,
the concept is bigger, yes, ma'am, than the term,
right?
What you mean, right, ma'am, alternate care for children can be one component, and then you say differentiate,
yes,
then
ma'am,
it is all the full concept you're talking about. But the moment you use the word explain the concept of alternative care, then we have to do the distinction.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Who's next? Sonam, you raising hand?
Yes, ma'am.
And then set the show. Sonam, you're ready? Ankur, kindly switch off your video. Sonam, are you ready?
Hello, ma'am?
Yes.
Ma'am, actually, I thought this is Sonam Varshane you're talking to.
Whoever is ready, please show your question.
No, ma'am. Ma'am, Sonam Das, I'm not ready. I have no question.
Is Varshane ready? Is Abhinav Goswami? Because Abhinav is raising his hand. And Abhinav, are you ready?
Should I go, ma'am?
Yes.
Okay. I'm just sharing this. Can you see?
Yes.
This is
LLM.
Yeah, LLM, second semester, Comparative Intellectual Property Laws. So I have divided this question paper into two parts. Part A.
We will not talk about the full question paper just now. We'll just look at one question.
Okay, the first question we can look at.
Yeah.
Okay, should I read it?
Yes, please.
the lack of guidance in the Bern Convention on works that are the result of joint creativity has led to a variety of different approaches in Bern Union members. It is undesirable for such diversity to continue, and it is now time for a more coherent approach to be adopted, critically discussed with reference to copyright law of India and United States. This is a bit suggestive question. It is already providing a direction to the students.
We do not want your response as yet.
Okay.
No guidance, because students will only read the question.
Okay.
So we need somebody else to respond. What do you think of the question? This is LLM. And what do you expect to write if you were the student? When you said Bern Union members, Abhinav?
Yes,
ma'am. Either US and India are part of that?
Yes, ma'am. United Nations used to be, but it is no longer the member. So it provides a thing, no, ma'am? Because it earlier used to be, then it left because of this reason only, the question of joint creativity. So it provides a great implication what issues he.
Yeah, but the quotation is saying approaches in Bern Union members and US is no more. Then the quotation is a bit outdated.
Yeah, true. But so what is the other way to include United States? Because it provides the best possible issues concerning the topic.
Mm-hmm.
So I should rethink about it.
And it's
it.
A okay. quotation from where?
It's a quotation from the WIPO Convention Treaty, which mm-hmm. was based on this Bern Convention revision.
So anyone who has a suggestion as to what you think you will be writing as an answer to this question? So who's making this sound? Anyone who knows IPR, copyright?
No, ma'am.
No one out of 26 people?
Ma'am, we know, but we have forgotten intricacies of the subject.
Yeah, but what is it that we are expecting here? Critically discuss with reference to copyright law of India and United States. So what all are we asking here? We are talking about Bern Convention.
He wants that, what is the lacuna which exists in the Bern Convention?
Hmm. No, because there is a lack of guidance in Bern Convention. On this specific area of joint creativity.
Joint creativity.
That are the result of the copyright work, which are the result of joint.
In the second one, he wants that we should adopt such approach which should be coherent and it should not be diversified. You know, do you want this type of answer?
I am expecting, I am provided a suggestion, but I'm not forcing the students to go into this direction. They can also give their arguments for diversity also. So this is just a bit of suggestion. Rest is up to the students what they have to say about it.
Right.
Are we supposed to tell how different the copyright law of India and United States are and where the diversity lies, and this should not be there? Are you also asking for suggestion or something? Or what?
No. You have to provide the comparison, but only in respect to joint activity, not in general.
Yeah, okay. So are there, no, because what I'm learning from the question is that Bern Convention doesn't have anything on this aspect.
Yes, ma'am, because this
and,
is the
the Indian law has it and United States law has it, and they have got different positions on this. Is that correct?
Because of the national, right. Yes, ma'am.
So then, if the it is undesirable for diversity to continue, and it is now time for a more coherent approach to be adopted. When was this statement made?
This was 1996.
So from 96 to till date, has anything happened in the Bern Convention?
No, because of the difference of opinion. No. Between India and United States. India, UK on the one side, United States on the other.
And the other countries are silent?
They are more or less divided on the on these lines only. Also.
So then you are expecting them to also trace the discussion which has happened since 1996, because of which nothing has still come in one convention, or what?
Not for all the countries. That is the reason I have pointed out two specific countries, what issues they have, what they
But if IPOS wrote this in 1996, mm-hmm. so 1996 to now is 24 years. So in 24 years, if nothing has moved, so do you mm-hmm. want some comment from the student about this aspect also? Or you are only saying, actually compare copyright law on the subject between India and United States?
No, ma'am. I am expecting the students to comment on this thing also, why there has not been no step towards this thing till now. Actually, mm-hmm. there have been steps, but because of the difference of opinions between these countries, the agreements have always failed.
Mm-hmm.
The last attempt was 2012 in China, but it all also failed. So there have been continuous efforts, but all in vain.
Because for me, the question is that why have you picked? Because if it's a, because Bern Convention is worldwide category, that I'm thinking.
True.
So if you have picked up two countries,
yes,
and but developments have taken in some other countries.
Mm-hmm.
Whether the student would be tempted or will be required to address, because you are saying that something happened in China but didn't come through.
Hmm.
Whether they will be pointing out the developments in the Bern Convention or the discussion relating to it also, in addition to comparing the law in India and United States, or not?
I'm not expecting them to write about international treaties or international agreements, because then it will become too broad. I'm only focusing on the national laws of India and United Nations and United States, and what is there that is restricting these countries to come together into this issue, to solve this issue.
Mm-hmm.
Mainly the national laws, comparison of the national laws.
Okay.
It is a 20 mark question, so it will be like a 5-6 pages.
But I do not know enough on the subject for me to know that when you're talking about absence of the joint creativity output products.
Yes, ma'am.
Then whether it is sufficient information there, because he was just saying that no lacuna in Bern Convention, and then decide how the India and United States have dealt with those lacuna. That could be one approach.
Yes,
and whether that will be too big, or whether it is that the issue of the products of the works of result, no, works that are result of the joint creativity, mm-hmm, is sufficiently mm-hmm. big area for people to write for 20 marks at the LLM level.
It is quite big, ma'am, because there have been many case laws in India itself, because mm-hmm. it is like a current issue. Many books are being written in joint authorship with mm-hmm. agreements and all. So this is there is huge material, but it is up to the student what he chooses to write, what cases he wants to cite, and what laws he wants to mention, because it is very broad based. I will say it is very broad for a 20 mark question, so he has to cut itself out.
Then you think you need to curtail it if it is very big?
But ma'am, I can't do it, because the reason is if I only tell that discuss with reference to copyright law of India, then the comparative intellectual property law, the heading of the paper will be like, it will be futile to just discuss India or United States.
No, that's not my point. I'm just saying that because if you yourself are saying that some students may write this, some students may write that, no,
yes,
and they are all justified in doing that. Then in evaluation, how would you decide that whether the student who has written, you know, half of the information and the other student has written the other half?
I will be more focusing on the suggestions, which will be based on the information.
But there's nothing to like, say suggestions. You're saying critically discuss. It's only pointing out the problems, not necessarily the solutions.
Like what he has to say about this thing, like it, the last line of my question, it is undesirable for such diversity to continue. It is now time for a more coherent approach. So what he has to say about it, why it is wrong, and why coherence is needed, or why diversity is like should be there, or for the reason, whatever. So this is, you are right, I'm understanding that, but yeah, but it is this question is such which provides a great liberty to students. It depends on his understanding how he attempts it, and it is LLM paperman. So we
that's fine, Abhinav. For us, LLM is also mean that is an external examination, and if the question framed is giving a lot of leeway to the student, the teacher, if they are aware of that this is a leeway possible, then it's okay. But many a times the teachers still have a very set understanding of what should be given as an answer. When that happens and the student hasn't written that, he's written something else, then he or she suffers because of that. So just gonna think about for me there are three things which needs to be talked about here. One will be this whole development of what is the context in which the statement came. Mm-hmm. Then what has been the development since then? Then you will mention how this has been dealt with in India and how it has been dealt with in the United States. And then you are saying you're also wanting an evaluation to determine which is better.
Yes, ma'am. Because only then I can understand that the student has understood the concept and he is able to like put forward his own opinion. The subject is such.
So do you think it could have been also said that critical discuss and give your views on the appropriateness of the laws?
This is the point I will definitely take into
consideration. I'm going to think about it. It's a good question. But when you just think that when you say critically discuss, for me, I do not see necessarily my opinion as being part of it.
Okay. Thank you.
So who's next?
Ma'am,
Ma'am,
one question.
Yes.
Ma'am, when we read the statement, it is undesirable for such diversity to continue. This statement, ma'am, isn't it like we also have to give suggestion or talk about the possible solution or anything of that sort? If we look at the statement per se.
No, it may be that I will tell you what has America said, what England has said, what China has said. I can say all that. But what I am saying, I do not have to give that. They will say the context in which this statement was made, that why we made this statement in this context. So they may just describe that what all has happened.
Okay.
So it is left to the student in that sense. Some of them may give their opinion, some of them may not give their opinion.
The
question specifically doesn't ask that.
Yes, I'll mention that later.
Okay. But could it be a little hidden question through this statement as well?
Say that again.
Ma'am, could it be like not specifically expressed question, but a hidden question in the statement? It is undesirable for such diversity to continue as such. Implied question.
Because it says critically, if it was just critically discuss the above statement, but it has got also given a focus. So therefore, I am not very sure that how much of this information and the answer has to be focused on the statement, critical analysis of the statement itself, and how much of it is on the critical analysis of the laws in India and US.
Could we say that an answer with an opinion or suggestion would be a better answer then?
It's just a question of whether, because if we don't put it there and some students haven't given their own opinion, will I be seeing this as a minus in the answer? That's my question.
Right.
That's the only thing. Otherwise, so it's fine. If I say, okay, because sometimes we do decide when we hold up at the teacher's meeting, that okay, if he says so, it's okay. If he says something more than this, this is what is expected also, they will give more marks. But you're not going to take away. No, it's kind of a standalone question also, without your opinion also fine. So it's a first-class answer. But there's certainly they've done something more, because we didn't specifically ask them. then we'll make it an excellent answer. But in that sense, it is in a sense, it's kind of saying that you are not intelligent enough to think about that other aspect, which I did not put it out there.
Okay.
Who is next wants to share your question? Anybody raising hand?
No, ma'am.
You're all done?
I have framed one question, but I'm not sure whether it's in correct form. Should I share?
Your choice. So these are all practice sessions. You want to make use of it, please do. Is there a possibility of you to shift the orientation to be changed? I can't read. You read your question.
Ma'am, I have written, explain the concept of essential religious practice test, ERP test, in the light of recent judicial development. Comment on the ERP test vis-a-vis Sabrimala judgment.
Now, what is ERP test? Essential
religious practice test.
Is it a usually used term, ERP test?
Yes, ma'am. It has been used. It was evolved by Justice Gajendra Katkar while delivering a decision in Bombay High Court.
Essential religious practice to samajh mein aaya. But whether this short form is as popular?
Yes, ma'am. ERP test is now used.
Okay.
But
now tell me how is the second part not included in the first?
In that area only I was confused, because if we trace down the evolution of ERP test, we have to go back to the precedents from where it started. However, in the Sabrimala, they have given a little different view from what they have been following in the past decisions. So I thought, in order to emphasize more and to get an idea whether the students are up to date with the current scenario ongoing, I should specifically mention this part, that you have to comment on ERP test vis-a-vis Sabrimala judgment. So, supposedly they...
Are you saying that, when you said concept of essential religious practice test, is that a concept or is that a test?
Ma'am, it is a test.
Then why do we write concept? What is it that we are expecting in this as an answer? My sense of the question is that we are, is there a tracing of development of this test? Has it changed over the years, or that has been the same, what Gajendra Kalkar said in so many decades ago, it is still the same till Sabrimala, or there has been developments test over the years?
I have to answer the question.
No, I'm just saying that this is my question. When I read the question, this is what's happening in my head as to what is it that I'm supposed to write on this one. You say explain. So explain is not tracing the history. Anyway, one is assuming that there is a clear guidelines available today to say this is what the test is about. Certainly, I have a issue with the concept and test, both the word being used together. So concept can be the essential practice, but the moment you say test, then it's not a contest concept anymore. And I can see that your focus is not. So, do you want to say that you know what developed, what kind of changes, or what has been the difference in the approach taken in Sablimana, in the establishedness, or whatever?
Yes, ma'am. I want to comment on this.
You can think on those lines and rephrase.
Okay. So should I?
Yeah, I think we will need to rephrase it. Because for me, I don't know whether you agree or not, but I think concept and test cannot go through.
Okay.
There's a comment on the ERP test vis-a-vis Sabarimala. That's kind of this focus. At the same time, because you are not asked for them to trace the history in the light of the judicial decision development. So for me, in fact, the test has also developed differently over the years. And if it has been developing over the years, whether Sabarimala has made a very major departure from the development in a substantive manner, it has not made those kind of changes in the earlier development. So the moment you're saying that you're wanting them to talk about different cases, my sense of that will be that different cases took it into different directions. Or has it remained static over the years?
Instead of mentioning to comment specifically on Sabarimala.
No, that's okay. Sabarimala specifically, I understand. I'm asking you the question because I do not know the subject again. I'm asking you whether the test has developed, because the moment you say, explain this in the light of the recent judicial developments. So this is a recent development, judicial development, so that's Sabarimala only, no?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
So then, you know, said that no, just explain the concept. But explain doesn't make sense. Explain and comment don't go together. In the previous one, you're saying explain with the recent judicial development. Then you're saying comment. Sort of confusing it.
So I'll remove one part from the question and I'll keep it till recent judicial development.
Ye question kiske liye hai? Which students?
This is for LLM second semester.
So 20 mark question, how many marks? 25. Kitne number ka question hai?
20 marks. So it will be a lengthy.
लेंदी कहाँ आप तो recent development की बात कर रहे हो, so what are the other recent cases that you are referring to?
सनी शिगनापुर will be covered, हाजी अली दरगाह will be covered, there are other मतलब n like approximately 6-7 major decisions which will be covered when they'll start discussing on this topic.
So no support because no, what are the cases which you know triple talak will fall in this?
Yes, ma'am.
Which are the judgments?
That triple talaq judgment will also be covered under this because it will again talk about essential religious practice. Then Sabarimala decision will be covered. Then there is Shani Shignapur Mandir decision where and bar on entry of in issue. Then Haji
Ali. No, the question, Priya, the question I'm asking you is, whether in each one of these judgments, the test has been developed or applied differently as compared to Sabarimala, because Sabarimala you're pointing out specifically. So are you suggesting that in all other cases they have taken the same approach, but in Sabarimala they have taken a different approach?
No, ma'am, I am not suggesting this. That in all the other cases they have taken similar approach, while in Sabarimala they have diverted from what they have been.
So are you saying that they have taken different approaches in all these cases?
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
If they have, they then have why point out Sabarimala separately?
Because this is the most recent decision.
So how many years are you going in recent? How recent is recent?
5 years.
Then why 5 years is recent? Why 5 years is recent? Why not only current year? So for me, that's a little, you know, I'm a little unsure as to what is the emphasis, your emphasis on Sabarimala. So they should be spending a lot more time on Sabarimala compared to the other cases. Is it?
Yes, my focus will be primarily on Sabarimala judgment.
Okay. Yeah, so just think about it and rephrase. You certainly need to rephrase because the concept and test do not go together in any case. But why don't you want them to comment on the recent developments on this test?
I want them to do all the three things. They have to explain the concept. They have to talk about the...
But where is the concept? It's a test. It's not a concept.
So what are the essential ingredients to be kept in mind while applying the test? Secondly, instead of mentioning recent judicial development, I can ask them to explain it in the light of judicial development so that it will take down the history over
a judicial one is Priya, development or developments, and whether you want to use the word development or do you want to say judicial decisions. Is there a difference between the two?
There will be a difference.
So do you want development or decisions? These are the small things we have to just keep track of. I think we need to close this meeting and start the third one.
Okay.